Alright, hey guys, I'm trying to find a good angle somehow. Ah, that's good. Okay, so I am going, in this video, I'm going to show you guys one of my cameras in specific. The last time I was introducing you all types of cameras. I'm gonna put the link of the video in the comment section, like in the description section underneath this video. So in case you want to check out what kind of cameras I currently have with me and what I like about these cameras, yeah, that's a nice video to see as well. But today I would like to introduce you one of my cameras specifically and more detailed, and I was thinking to actually also show you guys some examples of pictures I took with this camera. That would be actually a good idea. So I am gonna show you guys this camera. It's my first camera that I had. My first camera, which is similar to a DSLR, but this is actually not a DSLR. This is something in between a compact camera and a DSLR. So it has kind of a different format. But actually and honestly, that doesn't necessarily matter. It matters more how what you want to use the camera for, and also this camera shoots in RAW, so you can also actually edit it in the same way, the pictures, and the quality is basically, yeah, it's pretty similar, to be honest. But a large format camera, of course, has more pixels per image, so it has a better quality for sure. But as I said in the last video, the quality of the picture or the quality of the camera, the resolution of the image, whatever, doesn't necessarily matter as long as you get out of your comfort zone and you actually take the courage to own the moment and to actually take the picture. Because you can have the best camera in the world. I know people who have such good cameras and they just have the camera lying on their shelf and they're not using it. So what is a good camera for if you're not using it, if you don't dare to take a picture or create that moment? Alright, so this camera, I can just get into the story a little bit if you're interested about the story of the camera, but I could actually also in this video try to I'm going to tell you the story of this camera and why it means so much to me, and then I'm going to show you some examples of pictures I took with this camera so you get maybe a little bit inspired as well. And you're gonna go out today and you're gonna take some pictures nonetheless, what kind of camera you actually possess. That'd be nice for sure. Alright, so this is, as I said, something between a DSLR, I can put the exact name in a little bar underneath the cam. So you can actually take off the lens of this camera as well. I have another lens, it's quite a big one, but I don't like to use it that much because it zooms in too much and then I can't come close enough to the person anymore, and then the actual like image changes. I also like to take pictures where you can see some of the surrounding, or actually if I take a portrait, I want to be close to that person so, you know, they kind of feel comforted, and yeah, the quality of the portrait just gets much different when I'm actually close to the person and kind of take care of them or something when I stand by close. And when I'm using the long zoom lens, a few photographers, they use like a zoom lens to take portraits, because you can have a nice, if you zoom it gets really complicated, but I'm gonna try to explain to you guys. So if you have a zoom lens and you're gonna zoom out and all the way zoom in all the way, you will have a blurry background automatically. You don't even have to use the portrait mode on your camera, and that's how you get quite nice portraits. But just the actual portrait is gonna be different when you actually stay close to this person and you dare to kind of comfort them. So that's a decision you can make. You can either use the portrait mode, or you can also just do it in the after editing, or you can use a zoom lens. So I like to actually use a small lens, like, yeah, and then I like to be close to my subjects. And this camera is quite nice for that reasons. But I love this camera most to take landscapes. As well, because it has this, because it is in something in between a DSLR and a compact camera, that's why it has this different format, and that's quite nice for landscapes in my opinion. All right, and it has different modes. I'm gonna come a little bit closer and you can see that. So it has the auto mode and art mode. I told you in the other video a little bit about that. And you can film here. You can put the camera in this mode, or you can actually just press this button and it films as well. Then you can drag out the screen, so you could like record and you can still see what you record. For instance, if you record yourself like I'm doing it now, I can see what I'm doing because I flipped the screen like this too with the camera that I'm recording on now. Right, then this is quite easy for sure. This just viewing images, deleting images. This one, no fucking idea what this is about. Sometimes I press random buttons, and if I need to find out something else, to be honest, because I have so many cameras, I also have to look up stuff in the internet every now and then. So I don't know, a lot of people, they buy one camera and then they kind of expect that they know the whole camera and all kinds of like aspects or functions of this camera, but it's more about finding your technique as a photographer and just like accessing different tools, like here with this camera. So it's a little bit about getting into a routine and then just, you know, using the camera towards your favor. And if you realize you reach the limitations of the camera, you might be able to look up some more facts about the camera, or you might actually want to switch the camera. But the ideal scenario, and that's how I try to use my cameras or get to know my cameras, because I told you in the other videos a little bit about the personal connection you have with your camera. So the ideal scenario for me is to actually be able to use the camera without looking at it. So I can use most of my cameras by closing my eyes, and I know what buttons I would need to press and what kind of effect it will have on the final result. That's how I try to get to know my cameras, and therefore I don't actually need to know all functions of the camera. That's like what happens when I realize I reached the boundary. Yeah, maybe a little bit like when you buy a phone, you're not looking at the instructions, right? Do you do that? Like, do you go through the whole handbook? You would just switch on the phone and try to teach yourself. So that's how I kind of would like to encourage you guys to use your cameras too, because yeah, I don't know, a camera is not any different from any other technological item. They should be easy to be understood, and if they're not, you might be able to look up another video, or it's just not a really, yeah, good camera. But just don't feel guilty for not using all the functions. I have the feeling a lot of people feel really guilty to use when they have a really expensive camera and they're not using all the functions. Like, this is not even, or that's not necessarily like a must. Okay, then you have the lens. This one is a 14 to 42 millimeter lens, and you actually have to unlock it when you use the camera, so you just have to zoom it out. And now it becomes interesting, this camera actually has no lens cap anymore, because I told you in another video actually that I carried this camera around for a whole year while I was living in Australia after I finished my high school. I moved to Australia and I took this camera with, and yeah, and I really seriously had it with me every fucking day. And I also went into a walk in a rainforest, and that's where I lost the lens cap somewhere on the way. The story is quite interesting, because it started to rain and I was kind of like, it seemed like I was the only person on the track still, and it was like a circuit, and I was like, well, if you go back now, or if you like just continue walking, it might be like the smarter move to just fucking get your ass back to the car where your friend is waiting. So I decided that I'm gonna like let go of my lens cap for safety reasons, personal safety reasons, because it was quite stormy. Like, there was trees which were fallen like over, and I had to climb up these, and I was full of mud, and there was like leeches crawling up like my fucking like feet, and they were starting to suck my blood, and I was like, what the fuck am I doing here? I gotta get out. Like, this is getting kind of like super dangerous. Like, and I hated myself so much that I was so stubborn that I needed to do this check, all kinds of stuff. So it was really kind of risky, and I thought, man, this lens cap is now the least of my worries. So that's the story of this camera as well, a little bit. Like, I love that, you know, on the cameras that you're using and that you love, you can see some traces too. Like, for instance, here there's a little bit of like color still on the camera if you look at this, because I actually used it in a shoot where I painted myself. And I was full with paint, so obviously when I touched the camera, there was some paint on too. And yeah, you can see that still, so it kind of shows, you know, that it's been used, and it's been fucking loved. It's been, you know, it's my fucking, all of my cameras are like companions, and they are like witnesses of my life, in a way. They help me to discover new sides of me. Then here there is a little like sticker left from when I got it fixed in China. In the other video I also mentioned that this is what happened. Yeah, because I took it out every day. I also took it to the ocean. I took it into the rain, and this is definitely not a camera that is supposed to actually be used in the rain, but it was my only camera, so I kind of took the risk again and I just took it with me. And yeah, and then I eventually it broke when I think when I dropped it in the Philippines, it's when it switched off. And that was kind of tragic because I wanted to take so many pictures on that trip, but I kind of rolled with it anyways, and I just kind of took the moment to enjoy reality. I think that's a little bit of a problem that photographers have anyways, because we have this like obsession to always like think in images. So sometimes if someone would be talking to me, I would look at the person and their body language, and I would like see how they move, and I would actually like to take a picture of them in that moment. And I really like, even though I'm still listening to what they say, but I really have to force myself to focus on their words and not on how beautiful they look in this whole setting, you know, with like the background and the colors and the facial expression and the light coming in and all that kind of stuff. So it's always this decision. So now I actively choose when I have my days off, when I just want to like enjoy reality, and when I'm out on duty and I'm hunting for photos. But yeah, maybe that's part of why I'm starting to make these videos now, because I actually want to share this like photography knowledge with others. I think it can teach a lot about the way to look at the world. A lot of times I found that before I started to take pictures, I would really focus on, you know, on what did I actually focus? I don't know, I was maybe focusing on the content of what people were saying, and then I was also really like focusing on myself and how it made me feel and that kind of stuff, but in a really weird way, in a way that I wouldn't even admit that this is an influence happening, a direct influence. And then when I started to take pictures for the first time as a high school student, we had actually a course in the dark room, and we shot with a Canon, with an analog Canon camera, and developed the film then in the darkroom onto photo paper, light sensitive photo paper. So actually we didn't develop the film, we just kind of got like some copies onto the light sensitive paper. But that's when I actually learned how photography changes the way how you perceive reality, how you start to think in light and shadow and not in actual like people anymore, because before I was so focused on people and expectations and like, I don't know, an outcome of a circumstance. Maybe photography has taught me to actually enjoy the journey or something like that. Enjoy the way how everything evolves and changes. Yeah, well, that's actually already around 20 minutes again. I didn't really got much into the story of the camera. Maybe I could like tell you guys a little bit more about that next time again. And I also thought it would be a cool idea to actually take a video on how photography can change your life if you let it happen, or what it has helped me to discover. Yeah, I would maybe do that. Let me know if you would like that. All right, and then I would say bye. I hope this was not a shitty video. I didn't really put much content in it and also not much advice. But yeah, maybe you guys thought it was interesting to get to know a little bit more about me and why I like to be a photographer, or what makes me enjoy photography. Anyways, have a really nice day, and see you later.